These are your announcements. Evening service, Wednesdays, 6:30 p.m. Overflow Youth every Wednesday. Prayer, 6 p.m. Service, 6:30. Intercessory prayer every Monday and Wednesday, 6 p.m. Men's, Women's, and Youth Sunday School, 9:30 a.m. Women's Meeting, February 11th at 3 p.m. Living Springs, Spring Finger Foods. Missions Chili Lunch to Go, February 18th. Youth Sunday, February 18th. Mission 2024, El Salvador. Sign-up sheet on the back table. LS Library needs volunteers. See Miss Ginger in the library. Sunday special offering, building fund. Connect with us on Instagram and Facebook. Guest, please scan QR code to stay connected. Thank you for joining us. Have a great service.
Good morning, everyone. How are y'all doing today? Good, good, good. It's so good to see your wonderful faces here this morning with us. We're glad that you've joined us this morning. Lord God, we come before you today, Lord, with grateful hearts for your work on the cross, Jesus. We remember, Lord, the reasons that we have to praise you, God. And even then, Lord, I pray that you would just help us to remember who you are, God, and that that's reason enough to praise you this morning. Amen. Will you stand and worship with us?
Faithful, praise cause you're true, praise cause there's nobody greater than you. I'll praise, praise cause you're sovereign, praise cause you reign, praise cause you rose and defeated the grave. Praise cause you're faithful, praise cause you're true, praise cause there's nobody greater than you. I'll praise, praise cause you're sovereign, praise cause you reign. Praise cause you're true, praise cause there's nobody greater. keep it inside. No, I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? No, I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? No, I won't be quiet. My God, He is alive. We sing praise, Lord. Oh, my Lord. Praise the Lord. Oh, my Lord. We sing praise, praise the Lord. Oh, my Lord. Praise the Lord. Oh, my soul. I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? I won't be quiet. My God is alive. How could I keep it inside? Quiet, my God is alive. How could I keep it inside? Praise the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul.
In 1 Peter 1:18. The scripture says that God paid a ransom to save you from the empty life that you inherited. It was not paid with gold or silver, which loses its value. It was the precious blood of Christ, the sinless, spotless Lamb of God. The precious blood of Christ was shed for you. Hebrews says that His blood secured our redemption. It purifies us from sin, so that we can worship the living God. Hallelujah. Amen.
What can wash away my sin? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. What can make me whole again? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. No other fount I know. I am washed, I am washed, I am drenched in blood. All souls atoned by the blood of the Lamb. I'm not a slave to what once held me dead. How beautiful that cleansing flood. I am washed, I am washed, I am drenched in love. Yeah, washing all precious in the flow that makes me white as snow. precious. There is power in the blood of Jesus. How priceless, how precious. There is power in the blood of Jesus. How priceless, how precious. Upon your heart, no, not death, no, not hell could ever rip us apart. Drenched in love. Yes. to fulfill the law and prophets. To a virgin came the word from a throne of endless glory to a cradle in the dirt. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. God of glory, majesty, praise forever to the King of Kings. To reveal the kingdom coming and to reconcile the lost, to redeem the whole creation, you did not despise the cross. And for even in your suffering, you sought to the other side, knowing this was our salvation. Jesus, for our sake, you died. Yeah. Praise the Father, praise the Son, praise the Spirit, three in one. Till that stone was moved for good, for the Lamb had conquered death. And the death rose from their tombs, and the angels stood in awe, for the souls of all who came to the Father are restored. And the church of Christ was born, then the Spirit lit the flame. Now this gospel truth of all shall not kneel and shall not fade. By his blood and in his freedom I am free. For the love of Jesus Christ, who has resurrected me. Oh, we pray, praise the
sorrow may come and
strongest fight, but the cross has the final word.
It has a final word.
The cross has the final word. The cross has the final word. The there's nothing stronger, nothing higher, nothing greater than the name of Jesus. All the honor, all the power, all the glory to the name of Jesus. There's nothing stronger.
Cross. something about this old wooden cross being in this sanctuary this morning. And that it still speaks to the hearts, the minds of the people that are watching by our live service, watching in this sanctuary this morning. That this cross speaks to you in your life today. You are saved and born again because of not the cross, not the wood, not the nails, but the man who placed himself upon it. Amen. Because of Jesus Christ this morning, this cross still speaks because of Jesus and what he did upon it. Because he looked at you before you were ever born and said, I love you. Come on, y'all got to get this today. Amen. Jesus said, I love you. And he gave everything that day through the giving of his life, through his last breath. He gave because he says, I love you today. I love you. Jesus says, I love you. He says, I see your life. I see your hard times. And I see your good times. I see you struggling. And I see you victorious. And he says, I love you this morning. I love you. I've not forgotten you. Come on now. I've not forgotten you, says the Lord. The Spirit is here this morning to remind us of the power of what Jesus did upon that old wooden cross. And I love you. You got to get this in you today. You got to get this. The Spirit's saying this. I love you. You're not forgotten. I love you. I love you, says the Lord. I love you. I'm with you. I'd do it all over again just for you. You got to get this morning, church. You got to get it. I would do this for you all over again. He says this morning, if you'll take your eyes off all the stuff, come on. And man, we all got stuff. If you'll just start looking once again to where your salvation comes from, come on. Come on, come on. If you'll look at the cross in Jesus Christ, fix your eyes on him. Those things in your life would simply just fade away. Now you might say, Pastor, I've been doing that. And they're still there. Their problems are still in my life. But Jesus reminds you today that I love you. And if you will keep working on it, amen, he'll take it. He'll take it. He'll bless it. He's the God who makes something beautiful from nothing. He created you. He designed your life. He loves you. He loves you. Turn to your neighbor this morning and say, God loves you. God loves you. Come on, you can do better than that. Turn to your neighbor and say, God loves you. Amen.
God loves you. Amen.
God loves you. God loves you. Amen. Let's give the worship team a praise team another hand this morning.
Welcome to Living Springs. These are your announcements. Evening service, Wednesdays, 6:30 p.m. Overflow Youth every Wednesday. Prayer, 6 p.m. Service, 6:30. Intercessory prayer every Monday and Wednesday, 6 p.m. Men's, Women's, and Youth Sunday School, 9:30 a.m. Women's Meeting, February 11th at 3 p.m. Living Springs. Bring finger foods. Missions, Chili Lunch to Go. February 18th. Youth Sunday, February 18th. Mission 2024, El Salvador. Sign up sheet on the back table. LS Library needs volunteers. See Miss Ginger in the library. Sunday special offering, building fund. Connect with us on Instagram and Facebook. Guest, please scan QR code to stay connected. Thank you for joining us. Have a great service.
Hallelujah! Woo! Man! There we go. I'm excited to be in church today. Are you? The rain did not keep us away, amen. It just cleared up right on time, amen. I want to welcome all our guests, any first-time guests in the house today. I pray that you feel welcome and you feel loved as Jesus is right here in this room, amen. Don't forget, see our ushers if you need to fill one of these out. Also, we got prayer requests on the back. This This is a house that prays every Monday night, 6 o'clock. Come on. Come on. Also want to go ahead and dismiss the children. They're going to their classes. And again, welcome to Living Springs. We hope you feel loved and like family. Amen.
Woo! Take your tithes and offerings out this morning as we welcome, amen, all of our guests. Praise God. Ushers, you can come forward. It's a good day to be in the house of the Lord. Amen and amen. Jesus, amen. We studied this morning in our Sunday school class. I'm loving Sunday school. How about you guys? Amen. Where's all my guys at? Say yeah. Yeah. Come on, say yeah. Yes. All the men in our Sunday school and all the ladies too say woo. Yeah. All the ladies in Sunday school and all the youth say yeah. We need to hear youth at Sunday school. Come on now, Pastor Adam, been waiting on you. Amen. It's been so good. And we've studied this morning about the unity of the church. Come on. Ephesians, Colossians. And to hear those words from a man who sat in a prison cell, first of all, and said, you must be unified. Come on, y'all. Pastor Adam, I don't know if we're getting this today, but from somebody who could not be, saying that you should be, where his human liberties were stripped away, but you still have yours, saying you should be unified. And then going and past that saying, here's how you do it. Chop! Man, I'm telling you what, all the excuses are gone. God is going to bring fire, Holy Spirit, fire. Already is starting that process, but you must seek unity. You must seek one accord. You, right? You can't just point at your brother and your sister and say, well, yeah, are y'all seeking it? Because, well, no, you must be the one to say yes to the Spirit of the Lord, yes to church, yes to the people. 22, you got to love the Lord God with all your heart, soul, and mind. We like that part. It's the serving our brother the same way we struggle with. We must choose this process. Past circumstance. Doesn't matter if your bank account is full or not. Listen to me. God is asking you to serve, amen? And serve well. Because you can't take your bank account to heaven with you. Can't do it. But what you can do and what you will take are those things that you did for God and how you love somebody besides yourself. Man, I'm feeling the Holy Spirit. Brother Darrell, Brother James, I'm feeling him this morning. He's on this with us. He's going to grow us. But it's us choosing growth. It's us choosing to do things for somebody else, serving somebody else, going and knocking on somebody. How are you today? Do you need a ride to church next Sunday? How about Wednesday night? Can I help you, please, in some way? You've got to get that in your heart, amen? This is all great, right? Tithes and all. We're joyful givers. But God says you got to serve him now. It's just not about a bank account at a church being full, which it ain't. Right? Praise God. Right? We can do a few things. But it's more than that. Today we have a brother here that's going to talk about that a little bit. Thank you for coming, Mr. Terry. Thank you. And his beautiful bride. Thank you guys so much. Talking about how the Gideons share. Yeah. Lord, teach us to be givers. I thank you that we can give our finances this morning, but God, let us give our hearts. Come on, church, come on. Lord, let us. Not just going through the routines of church. Come on. Not just being lukewarm in church. I'm tired of that, aren't you? God's tired of that. It's time for change. And so, Lord, bring about the change that's necessary. As we give this morning, start to speak to our hearts on how we can give even more. It may not be money, but God, it could be time. It could be effort. Lord, all for your glory. Speak to your people today. As we give, joyful givers. Father, I thank you for the gift and the giver, but I thank you, God, for heart changes taking place. Jesus' name. Everybody say amen. God bless you as you give today. If you're giving online, the instructions are on the screen before you. Thank you for your giving heart.
Praise the Father. Praise the Son. Praise the Spirit. Three in one. God of glory, majesty. Praise forever to the King.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, everyone, for being here. Today, we have a very special guest. It is my pleasure to introduce to you a friend from this community, your community, Mr. Terry Scroggins and his wife. Can we give them a hand as they come this morning? Our brother Gideon coming to share about God's Word and the business of the Word of God.
Brother,
God bless you, Terry.
Appreciate you. Can everybody hear me all right in the back? Good, good. Turn with me to your Bibles to Isaiah 55, 11. Isaiah 55, 11. First of all, I want to thank you for allowing the Gideons International to be a part of your worship service here today. We are excited about being able to be a part of the local church. All of us are church members. No one can join the Gideons unless they're in good standing with an evangelical church. My pastor had to sign my application before I could join the Gideons, December of 1983. Sent me out to a church the first spring, which was be 40 years next month. This was the church building they sent me to. I thought the guy that signed me this church didn't have any idea. It just happened that way. That God sent me back to the same place that I started at. But I want to thank y'all. I want to thank y'all so much for allowing us to come and be part of y'all here today. Isaiah 55:11. So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, that shall not return to me void, but that shall accomplish that which I please, shall prosper in the thing whereto I send it. This word of God, we put these in hotels and motels all over, anywhere you stay the night, offshore drilling rigs. Bed and breakfast. Shirley and I rented a cabin up in the mountains in Pigeon Forge, and I found one in there that was 20 years old in that cabin. So anywhere you go to stay the night, we try to plant this silent witness. In its six-year lifetime, it'll reach about 2,300 people during that time. And when it gets worn and tattered, we'll cut the cover off of it, put a plastic little cover on it, and we send it out to the prison. We recycle them. So we're a bunch of frugal old men. We kind of take care of things, you know. So we believe in doing that, taking care of what God's given us. We take that, and we've done that for many years. We started the Gideons in 1899. Three men met at the YMCA in Janesville, Wisconsin, and they read the scripture that morning. They read Book of Judges, and they prayed. They got through. And this morning when we met for breakfast, we read the scripture and prayed. And every time we meet, we read the scripture. We're men of the book. That's what we do. Not just putting them out somewhere. We want to be men of the book. And we love to have some members. We'd love to have some of y'all join. If you'd love to, you're a businessman, professional man, own your own business, school teacher, whatever, business person, would like to have you join. Because see, we want to be men of the book. We want to be men of prayer. We want to be men of faith. We want going to be men of a separate walk. We're going to be men who witness. So, men of a compassionate heart, men who give. See, our first objective is to win men, women, boys, and girls to the Lord. We'll give them a copy of the Word of God, or we'll leave it somewhere, and that's what we want to do. But our first job is to win those there. In 1950, they did a survey of all the public schools in America. They got this through Lifeway and found out that in 1950, they did a survey of all the lower 48 states, public school children. How many school children do you think were reached by the gospel that had some connection with church in 1950? How many do you think were reached with the gospel? 65%. They did the same survey in 2010. How many school children were reached with the gospel in 2010? 4%. We're losing a generation of children. I love to come to this church and see all these children. I go to a lot of little country churches. I don't see children like this. I'm telling you. If I had a hat on, I'd take it off. My hat's off to you. All these children. I'm glad to see that. Thank you very much for your work that you do. And we're just a missionary arm or extension of the church. We used to do a lot with the Bibles and hotels and motels. That's only 8% of what we do. That's what we're known for. That's only 8% of what we do. 80% of what we do is giving New Testaments to school children. We give a little red testament. Some of y'all in fifth grade and up, y'all probably got one of these at public school here, because we go to all the public schools and give out this little red testament. Now, we've had some lawsuits, and we can't put the plan of salvation in the back like we used to. Can in all of our other New Testaments, but because of lawsuits, we've not been able to do that. But we do give these to the children. And we had some Gideons go down to Centerville, Texas. Now, we usually give you testimonies of things that happened from far way off, but Centerville, Texas isn't that far. And some Gideons went down there, and as our group usually does, we take the box of Bibles before we go in that school, and we pray in the parking lot. These children would receive this, and the Holy Spirit would work in their lives, and they would accept Jesus. That's what we would do. And we did that in that school. Those guys gave out the testaments in that school. And a boy, it was during COVID, so one year we did no kids, and one year we did fifth and sixth grade. I don't know which grade he was in. But he received a little New Testament. He went home and read that thing and was saved. Now his whole family goes to church there. So that's what we want to do. Now the first thing, the main thing we want y'all to do for us is to pray for it. Because we can't take any amount of Bibles or do anything without God's blessing. And we want our lives to be right with God. We want you to pray for us, to keep us and our families in line, and to do the things that we should do. That's the main thing. We want your prayers. That's the main thing we want. And the next thing I want you to do is to join. If you're a religious professional man, we'd love to have you. Love to have you come and join us. So we need some help. And we're all getting old. So the Gideon population now is a bunch of old guys. So we want some young guys to join. I joined when I was 29 years old. I'd love for some guys that age, younger, to come join. Got to be 21, we'll take you, and we'd love to have you. And you have many. We'd love for you to give to the Gideons. I'm gonna let the pastor take care of the offering, but we have these cards. There's a rack that we put in the back of the church this morning, and there's some real pretty little cards. I don't know who's writing those. Come up with these cards, but they're beautiful. And you can send Bibles. You can buy Bibles in someone's name in memory. Recognition of someone gets a promotion at their job or anything, any kind of thing, send that. Or you can just send it to people, saying we're thinking of someone that needs prayer. You can just say, listen, we donate some scriptures. So we have that rack back there. So anytime during the year, you can give. You can take one of those cards, send it, and our people will mail it, take care of it. So if we also, there's another way to give. I have some of these bulletins right here. And if you didn't bring any money today to give, you have a credit card with you. We have a thing in here. We pay by check or credit. telling you, the main thing we need is prayer. What we need. We need members. I thank y'all so much. Thank you for praying for us and thanking you for allowing us to come. We appreciate it very much. Thank you, brother. And give it to the school kids. See, this will go straight to them.
Wow. Praise God.
Thank you.
Amen. Awesome. Powerful ministry, yes. Something that's been around for a long time. I think God's in that type of ministry. Thank you, Brother Terry, for sharing. The extension of that goes greater and deeper and wider than we could ever know. You never really see all of the fruit that you do by your actions to give. To buy a Bible that Mr. Terry, another Gideon, can go and put into a child's hand in school. Wow. Man, a whole family has come to the Lord that way. I'm into that. How about you this morning? I want to see the gospel go forth. Praise the Lord. Yes, thank you, brother. Can we give Mr. Terry another hand? Thank you, guys. Thank you for being here this morning. We're preaching on the redeemed of God. Who are the redeemed? Please raise your hand this morning if you love Jesus with all your heart, soul, and mind. Yeah, we are the redeemed of the Lord. We are. Thank you, Jesus. And out of that place, that is a posture. You know, if you stand up straight, right, people tend to notice that. But if you're always hunched over and you got this poor, pitiful me on your face, people notice that too, right? Our posture in the Lord is that we would stand with God, right? Not with God in a situation or a way of Him where He's always abusive. It's never that way with God. He's never abusive to us. God is a God who restores us, redeems us. He lifts us up. He builds us up. In our Sunday school class, we talked about the building up of our faith this morning. The building up of a most holy faith. Praise God that God still builds us up in a most holy faith. And even straighter than that cross, amen, I want to stand up for Jesus. How about you this morning? Amen. In that position allows you to do amazing things. Even from just making the signs like Miss Jessica does, right? The slides. To serving in our children's department. To singing and leading worship. To preaching the gospel outside the four walls of this church. To showing up early to go to Sunday school. Maybe even going home and sharing the gospel with your family. The redeemed of God is a position in which we can do great and mighty things. Somebody please say amen to that this morning. It's more than just who we are. It's what we are. It's what we are. That's what last week we talked about the who, which is Jesus upon the cross. This week we're going to talk about the what. Amen, that's us. We are the redeemed of the Lord. What is redeemed? It's defined as a compensation for the faults or bad aspects of something. Aren't you glad Jesus came into your life? I had a lot of bad faults and bad aspects of my life too. But I'm so very glad that Jesus turned things around for me. And I'm so glad that He's turning things around for you this morning. Amen and amen. That God is still the God who compensated. He gave the price. He paid in full the price that we couldn't pay. He gave the offering that we couldn't give. By the shed blood of Jesus, mankind is set free. The way has been made. The promise given. The path created because of Jesus compensating for our loss, our aspects of life that were bad, our faults that we couldn't overcome. Another definition is to gain or regain possession of something. I like that. How about you this morning? That you are not just a lost somebody. You are a found believer. This morning you've been found by Jesus Christ. Jeremiah, we read about in chapter 24 how God sought out the people of God. He sought them out. He was looking. He was searching. Adam and Eve in the garden after they had sinned. What happened next? God sought out Adam and Eve, didn't He? Adam, where are you? I'm naked and afraid. We're not talking about the TV show, right? Lord, I've messed up. But God still loves you. Adam, God still loves you. Israel, Jacob, God still loves you, church, this morning. He's not looking for your perfection this morning. He's seeking you out, amen, as the redeemed of God, because you have been gained in that place, amen. And some have been regained again from that place of fleshly ways. There was an exchange given that was made possible through Jesus Christ. Church, say amen and amen. Redemption has brought us together under this banner, this message of Christ Jesus. Ephesians 1, turn there with me this morning, 7 through 10. It's our scripture for today that tells us something intimate, personal from Paul the Apostle that says this in Ephesians 1, 7 through 10. It should be on the screen. You can read along. In him, we have redemption through his blood. It is the one measure, the blood of Jesus, that has brought about the redemption of all mankind. What for? The forgiveness of sins. Every one of us have been sinners or sinners in a place of needing the cross of Christ to redeem us. Redemption bringing us back into alignment past our faults, past our bad aspects of life, and being in a place, amen, as a possession of God through his redeeming blood that was spilt for you and for me. The forgiveness of sins. According to the riches of his grace, which he has made to abound toward us in all wisdom and prudence. This morning, we're learning about the grace of God. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm saved because of grace, amen. You're learning something. You're getting some wisdom in you today. There's some prudence that's going to come on you here about this. Prudence meaning the ability to stand up into a thing, to accept the thing, to walk in a thing, amen. Having made known to the mystery of his will, according to what? His good pleasure, which he purposed in himself, that in the dispensation of the fullness of the times, he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth in him. Church, this is the word of the Lord. Amen and amen. I believe that God is working out a thing today. And sometimes we don't always get it right. And I've got a story here about some pastoral people, some priests. And there were four priests that they met. And they were just having a friendly gathering. They were getting together. They were sharing some woes. And one of the priests said, you know what? People come to us all the time and they share their problems. They share all these woes in their life. They share all these things with us. How about we start doing that together? Just the four of us. We'll just talk about it. Us sharing our problems, confessing one to another. And they all agreed. One confessed that he likes to go to the movies and he would sneak off away from his church to go watch a movie. And the second confessed that sometimes he would smoke a cigar. Oh my goodness. And the third one confessed that he liked to play cards every now and then. But when it came to the fourth, he wouldn't confess. The others pressed him saying, come on now, we told you our business. We've confessed our stuff to you. What's your secret? And then the fourth priest finally answered, it's gossiping and I can hardly wait to get out of here. Amen. It sounds like some of these priests might have needed a heart change. Come on. But aren't you glad that our salvation isn't based on our works? I'm so glad that God's not looking at my timeline of life and saying, boy, man, you're just not going to make it, son. There's a whole lot of things that you didn't get done. I'm so glad that God's redeeming grace isn't based on what I have done, but what Jesus has done. Come on, church, say amen. Thank you, Lord, for grace. Thank you, Lord, for grace. Number one, first point, our redemption is not based on outward performance, but an inward work. Amen. We say Christ died for our redemption, and I say amen to that this morning. But to truly believe, this is something that is sometimes hard for the believer. It's easier said than done. Though it's not hard for Christ because he already finished his work upon the cross. Now, saints, it's hard for us sometimes to believe, amen, that Jesus truly is the Redeemer of our life through all circumstances. Because when we look at our lives and things get hard, where's Jesus at? I thought he saved me, redeemed me. Can I tell you that blessings are not necessarily attached to redemption? Sometimes you got to walk through a thing. You got to go through a season, right, Brother Terry? You got to do something that's difficult in your life. But out of that process, that season, there'll be something that God is pointing at through the position of the cross, saying, if you'll just posture up, son, if you'll just live for me, daughter, I'll carry you through. I'll bring you through something that you didn't think you could go through. I'll let you accomplish something that looked impossible at first, because every single step of faith that we take brings us closer, amen, to that thing that will change our hearts. Somebody say amen and amen. I'm glad God didn't look at my life and say, oh man, your works aren't going to get you there. I'm glad that God looks at his son and says, thank you, son. You did it. Job well done. Job well done. In the hopes that one day we would hear those same words from our Redeemer. Great job, good and faithful servant. Well done. We want to accomplish these things sometimes in our own way, though. We want to work out our salvation. And I think a lot of the problem with the church today is that we haven't worked out the situation of dividing flesh and spirit. There's a lot of circumstances that we keep in our life because we just want to hang on to this thing that I've had going on in my heart for a while now. You know, a lot of people build their identity off of their pain, sorrow, and suffering. The gospel, though, when it comes into a life, redeems, it gains back, it regains something. The condition of the heart, somebody say amen to that. Where your pain, sorrow, and suffering no longer becomes your identity, but the cross of Christ becomes what exudes from you the most. Hallelujah! Amen, that when we can capture Jesus and his word and his spirit in our life, that is what people see, that is what people know. I love people that come from hard and difficult circumstances, and they walk into God's presence, amen. Not a church, amen. God's presence, amen. And they start to realize that I don't have to live that way anymore. Those old choices that I was making, I don't have to choose that anymore. I can be, amen, different. I can be set free. I can be joyous, amen, in all things. I can walk a new walk of faith, amen. I can be triumphant. But if you're building your identity out of what's going wrong, what's not adding up, what's not good in your life, and you gossip about that all the time. Oh, never going to make it, girl. Never going to make it, brother. The world's just too evil. Well, I'm tired of that. How about you? Amen. The Satan that is an enemy to us gets too much credit within the church. Too much. We talk about him way too much. And it's good to know your enemy, but it's never good to glorify him. He deserves no glory. Stop talking about all the problems, amen, of your life that Satan has caused by the power of his dominion and darkness, and start lifting up, amen, a song of praise in your life that God, amen, and you would do something victorious for once in a lifetime and once in a change of season, amen. Hallelujah. Stop taking these matters of the human heart and these hard things. Stop putting that on your list of things that have to overcome. And start to fix your eyes on Jesus, because he's already overcome those hard things for you. You see, Satan wants you to be confused. He wants you to be in the middle of circumstance. And we all have life and lives to live and circumstances that come. But if you'll glorify God, he'll lift you up. Amen. He'll exalt you. He'll bless you. He'll give things to you you didn't think you could ever have or possess. Since I've been following Jesus with all my heart, not just half of it, not lukewarm, but all of my heart, I've seen him open doors that I never thought would open. I've seen him take us to places that I never thought I'd get to go. I've got to see salvations happen all around me in my life. And it's for one reason only, because I love Jesus with all my heart, not just parts of it, right? I don't want to entangle sin nature with who I am in Christ. Because guess what? There ain't no sin in heaven. There's a couple of things that won't be in heaven, when sin is one of them. You won't be witnessing to sinners in heaven. Did you hear me this morning, church? Amen. The gospel will have been preached down here for the redemption of sin. But once we get there, there is no more of that. So you had better listen now. Because Jesus is talking to us. Amen. I once knew a man who was this way, who had evil passions and desires. Vile words would become spewing out of his mouth. He lived a life of selfish desire. He never was doing anything for anybody else except himself. And it took many years for this man's heart to change. And the reason that it was hard, amen, to change was because his heart was so hard. It took a lot of chiseling on God's behalf for this heart to smoothen out and start to soften. It took a while because I had to empty myself of selfishness and past hurts. See, I am that man. It took a while because my flesh is weak, and so is yours. But change comes when Christ comes. Somebody say amen to that. And when the heart becomes brand new and starts to soften inside of a believer, that heart change, amen, may take a little while, but it's taking place. Somebody say amen. And one day it'll start to manifest into this beautiful thing that God can use for his glory. Satan wants to fool us, though, that we're in a finished work. Can I tell you that's a lie this morning? And the message of the world today is that you can say a prayer and call it good. That's a bad theology. And if you believe that way this morning, you're in big trouble. And I do believe, amen, in that salvation moment. I believe, amen, for the redemption of sin that Christ comes to a believer. And the saving grace and work of Jesus Christ is in that moment. But you got to work out your salvation is what the scripture says too. With fear and trembling, you must follow God. The only finished work, listen to me this morning, is the work of Christ upon the cross. Everything else, everyone else, is still a work in progress. Look at your neighbor and say, God's still working on me this morning. Because he is. You're an unfinished work. You're something that still needs Christ. You can't say, I've reached my pinnacle, my place. I've been to the mountaintop and back again. Now, maybe you've been around this whole world preaching the gospel, but God, amen, is still working on you and me. 2 Corinthians 4:7-12, you can see it on the screen. It says, but we have this treasure in earthen vessels, that's you and me, and the treasure is Christ, we're the earthen vessels, that the exchange of the power may be of God and not of who? Us. You can't save anybody in your name. You can't heal anybody in your name. You can't do great works, signs, and miracles in your name. Church, there is only one name, amen, that can happen in, and that's the name of Jesus working through us. And he goes on to say, Paul says, we are hard-pressed on every side. Have you felt a little hard-pressed in your life? Listen up. Yet not crushed, amen. What a blessing in God that we are preserved by Jesus. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Have you been a little bit despaired lately? God says to you this morning, you don't have to feel that way. I'm with you. I'm for you. Hallelujah and amen. Persecuted but not forsaken. Struck down but not destroyed. Always caring about in the body the dying of our Lord Jesus, that the life of Jesus also may be manifested in our bodies. Amen. We have redemption. We are the redeemed of God because Christ is in us. This morning in Sunday school class, we sat there around the table. We put our hands on each other's shoulders and we prayed. And I said, brothers, this is Christ. This is unity. This is the work of the Lord within our lives to connect to him and to each other. And we prayed and you could instantly feel the Holy Spirit in that simple act of just putting our hand, amen, on a brother or a sister. There's power in connecting to Christ and connecting to each other. There's strength that comes, amen, from that sacrifice. There's power, amen, when Jesus comes and connects to us. There's power, amen, when God says, go to that them, encourage them, bless them today, amen. I love you. Bless you. There's strength in this. And God says to you, choose this. Choose this path. Choose this way. When a husband and wife come together, amen, two become one flesh. Why? Because there's strength there. There's one accord there. And getting married in the ways of the world, amen, that's not the answer. You must go through holy matrimony. Somebody say amen to that. Through one biological man and one biological woman. There is no other way. Because God does the miraculous when his name, amen, goes forth, not ours. You can't get married in Buddha. You can't get married in Allah. You can't get married in Muhammad. You must be married, amen, to Jesus. That we would be his bride. And he would be our bridegroom. And there's strength in that, amen. When I'm going through troubled waters, I go to my wife. I say, let's pray. Let's pray, baby, right? Let's pray. Let's lift up prayer, amen. Aren't you glad you got a spouse that prays with you? Hey, kids, aren't you glad you got parents that'll pray with you, amen? If you don't, we'll come pray with you. Just invite us. We'll come pray. Amen. I love connecting because God says this is the one accord. Jesus wants us to be tied in with him and tied in with each other. And this is the place of that we understand that God is doing this for us. But sometimes it's hard for a new believer because they must be discipled. Who will teach them? We have classes here. Amen. We talked about that this morning. We have an Ethos Bible School program. Amen, for you to biblically learn where Christ is in your life and the calling on your life. We have Sunday schools. We have Pons groups outside of the church, home groups that we connect. And there's more things coming. But you must be faithful now to connect to that brother or sister right next to you. Could you look at your neighbor for just a second? These are your brothers and sisters. You didn't personally invite some of these people, but they came because somebody said, come to church with me. These are the ones, amen, that God's called you to connect with. These are your brothers and your sisters that God's called you to serve. You can't be selfish in that. You must be sacrificial. You must be unselfish. Our brother came today because he was in his beautiful bride because they were unselfish. Sacrificing their time, their effort to be here to share about how the gospel is going forth. I want to connect to more people like that. Amen. Amen. Jesus reminds us in Matthew 5:10, blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. I want to walk through a thing with my brother and my sister. How about you this morning? But if you're always saying, not me, no, sir, I got enough troubles of my own. And there's a lot of selfish Christians in the world that will lose out on blessing because of their hearts being in the wrong place. But if you're willing to take a stand with Christ and say, I'm here for you. I will help you. I want to mentor you. I want to walk with you. I want to go through some things with you. How much does that mean? How much weight does that carry over into the kingdom of God? Tremendous weight. Because it was the exact example of Jesus to his disciples. He wasn't just saying, hey, come follow me, now go do that. He was saying, hey, come follow me, let me show you how to go do that. When you're teaching a child, right, you can't just give them a piece of paper with a list of instructions on it and say, hey, go figure this out, right? That doesn't work. There's more to this, right? And odds are that kid's just going to crumble that paper up and just throw it away and do it their own way. And the problem with the lost generation is because the church has been doing too much of that, Brother Terry, in the hopes that they'll get it. And God is saying, no, you must show them. You must example to them. Are y'all getting this with me? Y'all still follow me this morning? You must lead the way. You must be courageous enough, amen, to go do hard things with your brothers and sisters. You must. You must. You must. The reason that many Christians miss the mark is not because of lack of faith to believe originally. It's because they forget to continue to believe. They grow tired and weary. And Christ's work upon our hearts is never finished. Never. Not until the last breath, until Jesus says, it's done in your life and brings you home. There's a constant work taking place in our hearts because our life, your life, and the call upon God in you requires it. Amen. And God wants the rebel to come out of you. And as Paul is reminding us in Ephesians 4, this I say, therefore, in testifying the Lord, that you should no longer walk as the rest of the Gentiles walk, in the futility of their mind, having their understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God. Because of the ignorance of that is in them, because of the blindness of their heart, But who, being past feeling, have given themselves over to the lewdness of to the work of uncleanness with greediness? If indeed you have heard him and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus, that you put off concerning your former conduct the old man which grows corrupt according to deceitful lusts, and be renewed in the spirit of your mind, and that you put on the new man which is created according to God in true righteousness and holiness. I underline something there in your scripture. The spirit of your mind, renewed in the spirit of your mind. By the Spirit of God, your mind comes alive again to produce this new man according to God in true righteousness and holiness. You must have the Spirit or you will not know how to love. You must have God or you will not know how to love. The Holy Ghost, amen, to have the gifts of the Spirit, to produce the fruits of the Spirit. We wait on the Holy Spirit. Why? Because he's our everything in this process. And the church, amen, that grabs a hold of the Holy Ghost is a church that will thrive. It may walk through seasons of hardship, but it will thrive. We've been here for over 5 years, going on 6 years, amen. And God has placed us in this house, amen. And we've seen seasons come and go that are good and bad. Can I tell you the next great thing is about to happen here at Living Springs Church? Are y'all following me this morning? Y'all hearing these words? The next great thing, amen, God wants to do is fixing to occur right here at Living Springs Assembly of God Church. And it will be because you've connected, you've chosen to be unselfish people, fully in love with Christ Jesus, full of the Holy Ghost in your walk, amen, doing things, amen, because the Holy Spirit is telling you to. And you just say, yes, Lord. Say it with me. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. That's what he wants to hear from your mouth, because it's coming from your heart. Because out of the heart a man speaks. Joseph, stop saying you're sick. You're not sick. You've been redeemed by the cross of Christ. You've been made well. You're no longer a sick man. That's not your identity. Your new identity is Christ, who has overcome death, hell, and the grave for you. To say it, believe it with all of your heart. Amen? That's what people need to hear from you. That's your identity. It's my identity. That's who I am. Yeah? Yeah, I got some work to do in my life. Sometimes I feel fat and lazy. Everybody does, right? But can I tell you, that's not who I am? That's not my identity? That's not who I am. I'm a worshiper of the true one living God. I am his redeemed, born again, washed in the blood, amen? That's who I am. That's who you are. But you got to believe like that. Your heart's got to be full of that wisdom, knowledge, that prudence, like we just read about, so that you can say it. Number two, really quickly. Lauren, hey, come back up, Lauren and River, please, if you don't mind. We're going to worship a little bit. I got a lot more. We got a lot more pages here, but when I get through all this today, I was going to talk a little bit about dispensation. Really quickly, dispensation is a period of time within the time frame of the gospel that you hold in your hand, right? We're living in the dispensation of grace in this current period, which came out of the dispensation of the law. Okay? Follow me, right? Jesus came. He offered grace to the fullness, right? We have redemption. We have forgiveness of sins, right? Eternal forgiveness of sins, which wasn't before through the law. So a new dispensation was created through Jesus Christ, which also brought, amen, the law of man. It wasn't the law of the Scripture, it was the law of man, which counterbalances, which balances out, amen, grace. We're struggling with the law of men right now in our nation, right? We're struggling with these lawmakers, right? But God's grace is sufficient, amen? And there'll be a new dispensation, amen, when Jesus raptures us, and he is going to come for us. Amen. He's coming. Once again, he's coming. Ready your hearts. Ready your hearts. And that'll create a new dispensation of the 7-year period, tribulation, right? We're going to be watching that from up heaven. Amen. But for those that remain, we should pray. The Jewish believers will have to go through that dispensation, that 7-year tribulation. God will not leave his people, though. He will protect them. As Gog and Magog, as Gog, the ruler of Magog, which we think is Russia, the northwest country, as in Revelation prophesied, revelated through John, culminates with other countries, Persia, modern-day Turkey, Iran. As those things start to come into alignment, which we're already seeing, right? We're already seeing all this stuff. New dispensation will occur. A new time will come. But God will protect his people. Yeah. He's going to protect his believers. And the hand of God will come upon Israel. They're going to go through a lot. We should pray for the Jewish people. Here in a couple of months, we're going to have a Messianic Jew come and see us. He likes talking about that redeemed place in Christ. Amen. Born a Jew. This whole mess about trying to become Jew, right? You're either born one or you're not. Dispensation. New season is coming to us. Are your hearts ready for the coming of Jesus Christ? Have we done enough? My second point was the work of Christ for our work. Ephesians, breaking that back down again in Ephesians 1, that we know his will. Christ has made his will known unto us. He's purposed these things that we would know his good pleasure. And God is sending us out to places. And I've been to several countries already in my life. Honduras, El Salvador, Costa Rica, Mexico. This year he's sending us to Estonia, Tunisia, and Germany. Why? Because the gospel needs to go forth. And the answer for us in spiritual growth is for the sake of the gospel. All for the sake of the gospel. Amen? And the gospel cannot go forth unless you're prepared to share it. The Apostle Paul, he sought out to speak on this matter. He sought out the will of God for his life by letting go of all of who he was to become a man truly God created you to be. And that same answer is for us today in the place, amen, of knowing that we've done the things God's asked of us. It's always been God's plan. God's great pleasure is having us all with him one day. All for him. All for the glory of the King. All for Jesus. And my closing today is simple. Are you ready to meet Jesus? Are you ready to meet your Savior in the air? If you were to call us today. I know we got Super Bowl tonight. But folks, if Jesus' trumpet sounds before the kickoff, right? I'm sorry, I'm not going to be here to watch the Super Bowl. Where's your heart at then? Love more? What do you love most? Do you love yourself? Your fleshly desire? Get one foot still in the world. Trying your best to be like Christ. But if you were to call us home today, would your heart be ready? I just want to invite you today. I want you to come to the altars. And I want you to pray. Take some time at the cross this morning. Write something down and leave it at the cross. Pick up this cross. Amen. This is a little wooden cross. But it's a reminder that the price has been paid. Amen. We all need to know this. One of us. There's some things I'm fixing to stick up here too. I've been carrying for too long. I want you to come and join me at the front this morning if you need prayer for anything. If you've been away from God, there have been things that have been holding you bound. The cross, the blood of Christ, amen, is still for you that can set you free. Jesus loves you. He says this morning, I love you. I love you. Would you bow your heads, close your eyes, please? You feel like you need prayer today because you've been carrying some burdens around? Come this morning. Don't let the burdens of this life, don't let your sin nature get the best of you. Come on. Come on, church. There's freedom in Jesus. There's freedom in Jesus. There's freedom at the cross, at the feet of Jesus. Come on. Amen. Don't carry these things in your heart and your life anymore. Give that up. Give up that bitterness. Maybe you've been hanging on to unforgiveness. God says, you can forgive. I'll give you strength to forgive today. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Maybe you're watching by live. And you're just wondering, I don't know. I don't know if I'm redeemed, I'm saved. I don't know. This morning, God is speaking to you, and he's saying to you, sweetheart, he's saying to you that he loves you. Amen. He wants to help you. He wants to bless you. He wants to give you a new path, a new direction, a new purpose. Amen. He loves you this morning. He cares for you. He died on the cross for your sin. That the process of life would come to you today. That if you'll just simply say, Lord Jesus, say this with me, congregation. Lord Jesus, forgive me of all my wrongdoings. Forgive me of my selfishness. Forgive me of pride. Forgive me of jealousy. Forgive me of envy. Forgive me of strife. Lord God, forgive me and take my heart, God, and wash it clean. Come on and pray that. Wash my heart clean this morning. Show me how to forgive. Come on, say it. Show me how to forgive. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. That I know that I will meet you in the air, Father. That if you came today, God, my heart is ready. I am right with the Lord this morning. Amen. If you said that prayer this morning, will you just applaud Jesus? Amen. 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 Thank you, Lord. We are the redeemed. We are the what God is working on. We are. It's us. Jesus is the who. He's the answer. But you must receive him as that in all aspects of your life. Amen. Thank you, Lord. You know, God doesn't want you tired and wore out. He doesn't want you dragging your feet through the mud. He wants your posture upright, amen? He wants you to be in one accord, strong in him, regardless of the things. This morning, do you feel stronger in Jesus Christ? Would you lift your hands up and say, amen, that's me, amen. Amen. Come on, give him a shout of praise. Amen. Amen, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father God, this morning, I pray for this sister. Come on, church. I pray for this sister. I ask you, Father God, to help us. The Holy Spirit says to you, Dorcas, you are loved this morning. You are loved. You are loved. You are loved. You never were not loved. God says, I love you. 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 He says, I love you more than you love your children. I love you more than you love your own life. I love you, says the Lord this morning. He says, you've forgotten some of that love, but he's going to pour his love into you. Hey, he's pouring his love into you, in the name of Jesus. Hey, yes, Lord. He's pouring his love into you right now. He's reminding you of his authority. He's reminding you of his grace. Right now, he's giving you his love. He cares for you. It's a warm embrace of the Lord right now. He's just, his spirit's just hugging you. He's just holding you. The Lord holds you this morning. He loves you. He's not forgotten you. He cares for you. You're his baby. You're his baby. You call your children that. And even more than you love your own babies, God loves you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Woo. Come on, church. This is your sister now. Come on. Thank you, God. Yes, Lord. Yes, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Woo. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. Come on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Woo. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Woo. He's working out the stuff right now in her heart. Amen. He's working out the stuff in your heart, Dorcas. He's saying, let go of that stuff. Come on. Let go of all that pain. Let go. Let it go. Let it go in Jesus' name. Let it go. Let it go. Yeah. That's not your burden to bear. That's not yours to bear. That's the Lord's. He's taking that right now from you. Oh, yes, God. Yeah. Woo. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, for loving her. Thank you, God, for loving your sister, your daughter, our sister. Thank you, God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. God says, I see your heart, the brokenness. Your heart's been broken so many times. People have let you down so much. The Lord says, I'm here to mend you. I'm here to help you. I'm here. I'm here and I'm not going anywhere. Oh, I'm not going anywhere, says the Lord. I'm with you now. I'm with you. He says, accept all of me. Accept me into all of your heart. Let all that other stuff go. Say this with me. Lord Jesus, take these things that I can't carry anymore. Lord Jesus, take this burden. Take the heart. Give me your love. Give me your joy. Fill me with your peace. Why'd y'all stop praying? Come on. Why'd y'all stop praying? Come on. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Woo. Thank you, Jesus. If this was you standing here, you want somebody praying for you this morning. Come on and pray. If this was you standing here, you want somebody praying for you. Come on. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you for love today. Thank you for the love of Christ. Oh, come on. Yes, Lord. Yeah. Yes, God. Just taking broken things and giving you a new thing. Fresh oil come from heaven to you. Fresh fire from heaven. Holy Spirit, fill her. Fill her, fill her, fill her. Woo, shanti. Fill her, Lord. Oh, come on. Wash over her, Lord God. Let heaven open over her life in the name of Jesus. Yeah, 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 yeah. God just says, drink that on in. Drink that on in. It's me. It's the Lord. Amen. He says, drink it on in. Come on. Shanti. Yes, God. Yes, Father. Yes, Lord Jesus. He says, don't run off. Don't run off. I'm right here. Stay near me, says the Lord. Stay near me. Desire me, he says. You've let too many more desire. You've let all these earthly things in your heart. Oh, no more of that. Come back. Thank you, Jesus. Welcome home. Welcome home, Dorcas. Hey, would you guys wanna come meet your sister? Come on. Come on. It's like a new baby. A brand new baby's been born. Amen. Everybody wants to hold the baby. Amen. There's a new work in you. Amen. God's gonna make you. He says a childlike faith is gonna rise up inside of you. You're just gonna believe for great things. You've been gone for far too long. Welcome home, sister. Welcome home. Welcome home today. Welcome home today. Come on in. Wrap your arms around your sister. Come on. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yeah. Oh, we love you here. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father God, for this beautiful Christian lady. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for her faith in you. Thank you for her love for you. Yeah. Oh, yeah, he's taking that broken stuff. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It's okay, God says. It's okay. Oh, he loves you so much. Come on, yeah. He loves you so much. He's just holding you right now. The Lord's just holding you right now. Come on now. Yeah, thank you, Jesus. Thank you for our sister. Oh, you came home. You did it. You did it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Bless her. Bless her, Lord. Bless her, Lord Jesus. Bless her, Father God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord God. on your sister, guys. If that doesn't move you, I don't know what will. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Jesus. Thank you, Father. Isn't it good to be a part of a family? Dorcas. Better than any Super Bowl I've ever seen, man. I'm telling you what. I'll take that every day of the week, please, Lord. Thank you, God. Lift your hands to heaven with me this morning, Lord Jesus. Would you win this city for you, God? Would you pour out your spirit in Palestine, Texas, God? Would you bring, Father God, those who don't know you to a place, Father God, where they would bow their knee and confess that you're Lord? Bring them, Father God, and show us how to go to them. Show us how. Show us how to love. God, let us not be selfish. Let us not be prideful here. Show us how to love, Lord, like you love through your Son. Father, forgive us of these selfish things. I pray, Holy Spirit, you rest upon us, God, that we'd have the courage to do what's necessary. There's so many, God, that need to hear your gospel. Teach us how to preach, Father. Teach us how to share. How to teach us how to love. Teach us, show us how. Thank you, Jesus. I just got to pray for this family, for the Valencia family. I just want to pray for you guys today. Yeah, there's a heaviness on you guys. And God wants to lift that up off of you. He wants to carry this off of you today. These things you've been worried about. Hey, Luis. God says to you this morning, I'm going to work out all things for your good. Amen? All things for your good, because he loves you, Luis. He loves you, he loves your wife, he loves your children. Amen? He even loves Jessica, amen? I'm kidding. He loves. He's going to work out all things for your good. Stop worrying about the future. The day has enough trouble of its own. Fix your eyes on Jesus and this woman and these kids, this family. Amen. Thank you, God. I just want to lay hands on you, brother. Pray for strength in this man. Help them, Father. At work, help him, God. Help him, God, at work. Help this sister when she's working with her kiddos. Amen. Help Jessica at the high school. Help her, Lord. Help her, Lord. Come on and pray a little bit longer. Help her, Lord. Help her. Help Shayla when she's at the high school, God. Help her. Help this family. Spirit, come to you today. Come into them and bless them. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Strength come to you. Joy come to you. Joy, 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 joy come to you. Joy come to you. In the name of Jesus, have joy. It will be your strength for the days to come. Thank you, Lord. Bless this family. I just cast darkness away from you, dark spirits away from you, lying spirits away from you in Jesus' name. Lying spirits, go in Jesus' name. Get out of here and go. That place, love come. Love. Love come and joy come. In Jesus' name, Lord, we thank you, Father. Okay. Amen. Anyone else need prayer this morning? The Lord's here. He wants to help us, encourage us. Amen. He's the God of miracles, signs, and wonders. Hallelujah. Yeah, brother. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Amen. Yes, sir. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, sir. Yeah. Amen. Come on. He does that. He knows where you need to be and who you need to be with. And I thank you, God, that you keep moving him, Father God. You keep lifting him up, Lord Jesus, God. The rut, Father, is not his. He doesn't live a life in the ditch, Lord God. He lives a life, amen, walking on the road of salvation in Jesus' name. Amen. He lives a life of joy. Amen. Of joy. Amen. Of joy, of salvation. Not sadness. Not sorrow. No. No. No more. No more, brother. No more sadness. No more sorrow. And in place of that, God says, I'm going to give you joy. Joy! Strength! Thank you, Lord God. Say this with me. Lord Jesus, take the sadness. Take my sadness. Take my sorrows. Take my sorrows. Take my pain. Take those things. Hallelujah. Take the sadness. Take the sorrow. Take the pain. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Come on, you gotta let go of that stuff before God can do something, right? Let go of that stuff. Sadness, no more sorrow, no more, no more. You have too much to live for, too much to be done, too much to do. Amen. Too much to do. It's time to turn the page. It's a new chapter, God says, the Holy Spirit says. This is your new chapter. It may be the final one too, but God says live it out to the fullest. Every day God's going to lift your hands, he's going to lift your arms just like I'm lifting. He's going to give you strength to do things you didn't think you could do. You're not finished yet, says the Lord. God says, I'm not done with you. In fact, in ways, I'm just getting started with you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Lord. For redeeming your person, your people. Like there's somebody here has a word for this brother. So before you leave, if you feel like you need to share something with him, just share this with this brother. I love you, man. Thank you for being here. And you got a really cool jacket on today. That's awesome, brother. I love you. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Woo! Woo! Yeah. Like we've had church today. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Stand with me. Let's sing that chorus one more time. Miss Lauren, lead us in that, please. Yes. Yes, it does. Thank you, Jesus.
The cross has the final word.
Yeah.
The Savior has come.
Sister Terry and his wife who came today. Let's give them another hand today. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you, Jesus, for loving us. Thank you, Jesus, for giving your life. Amen. Take that message with you today, please. Hey, there's some little crosses up here. If you feel like you can use that to witness to somebody, come get you one. Amen. I'm going to make some more. All right. This is who we are. The redeemed of God. Amen. I want to encourage you guys to have a very wonderful day. If you're traveling tonight for Super Bowl, be careful out there. God loves you, but you got to drive safe in the weather. Amen? Okay. He gave you a brain. He gave you a brain. Use it. Praise the Lord. Okay. Thank you all for watching by live. We love you. Have a blessed week in Jesus' name. We'll see you tomorrow night for prayer.